Good morning, class 9. In the previous class, we learned about Buddhism, the founder of Buddhism, and then we learned about the teachings of Buddhism, the Four Noble Truths, the Eightfold Path, and Buddha's attitude towards God. We also learned about the code of conduct, the karma, and stress on morality, the organization, that is the Sangha, the membership of the Sangha, the Ten Commandments, the Viharas. We also learned about the two different sects of Buddhism, the Hinayana and Mahayana, and how they differed from each other. Now today we are going to learn about the impact of Buddhism on the society and the nation as such. Buddhism made a lasting contribution to Indian culture, religion, art, and social life in the following aspects. Ahimsa. The doctrine of Ahimsa became a weapon against the ills in the society. After the rise of Buddhism, animal protection became a new culture. Mahatma Gandhi later used Ahimsa in the form of non-violent struggles against the British rule. Then, influence on religious life. Buddhism provided a challenge to Hinduism. They soon started a reform movement within Hinduism. The costly yagnas and sacrifices and rigidity of caste system were done away with. Those children, here I disagree, because the caste system is very much present in our society, and it is still thriving, not just in certain pockets but all over the nation. Now, influence on social life. Buddhism fostered intellectual tradition and exposed the weaknesses in our society. The weaker sections of the society who had been subjected to many atrocities, tortures over here, got an opportunity to have their say in matters of political and social life. Now let us see the political impact. The republics of Shakyas, Vajjis and Malas embraced Buddhism. Ashok and Kanishk made Buddhism their state religion. So they diverted from Hinduism. Cultural impact. Buddhism spread far and wide in Southeast Asia, China, and Sri Lanka. It had a far-reaching cultural impact in raising the prestige of India. There emerged close cultural contacts between these countries and India. Buddhism acted as a vital force between different cultures. And this we are not talking about in today's scenario, like SAARC or other Commonwealth nations that we have, G20 nations we have. But we are talking about the medieval times. Now, language and literature. Buddhism made valuable contribution to the field of language and literature. We have already learnt about the Jatak tales. A vast and varied nature of literature was produced in the language of the masses, that is Pali. The Tripitakas and the Jataks are the most important literary works of the Buddhists. Besides these, other literary works of importance written in Pali language are Mahavamsa and Deepavamsa, Divyadan, Lalitvistara, Saundarya Anand, and Buddhacharit are significant works of Buddhist literature written in Sanskrit. Now let us see the impact on art and architecture. Buddhism made immense, vast contribution to the evolution of art, bringing up of art and architecture. Stupas, chaitis, viharas, and rock-cut cave temples were their unique contribution. The stupa is a semi-spherical solid dome-like structure containing the relics of Buddha like hair, teeth, or bones. The stupas at Sachi, Bharhut, and Amravati are remarkable. Specimens of art surviving up to this day. The chaityas were rectangular halls with a semicircular roof supported by a number of columns. These halls were meant for worship. The viharas were the monasteries for the monks to live in. Later, when statues of Buddha began to be carved after the Christian era, there emerged several schools of art and architecture. Even during modern times, especially during the time of Ashok, stone cutting and chiseling of pillars required high technical skill. So there was so much of development in art and architecture. Now, like all good things, Buddhism also, there was a decline in Buddhism. Not totally, but then, yes, it lost its popularity. Split in Buddhism. The division of Buddhism into Hinayana and Mahayana sects brought about many changes in Buddhism. Its popularity and prestige suffered. Differences had begun to surface right from the Second Buddhist Council. Hinayana and Mahayana actually were only two major sects. There were 16 other sects and each had its own followers. So major ones were Hinayana and Mahayana, but there were 16 other sects. Buddha preached his teachings in Pali. After his death, Sanskrit, the language of the upper class, also came to be adopted. Now let us see what is the third reason for the decline of Buddhism. The monks and nuns started living a luxurious life. There was deterioration in the spiritual life. They were they started to lean towards luxuries in life rather than concentrating on the spiritual things. Buddhist sanghas received patronage of royalty and had become very rich. So money made them corrupt. The monks and nuns used the riches for their personal benefit, not for the benefit of mankind, but for their personal benefit. They began to lead a worldly life. Therefore, the religious decline was not a surprise. Now, reforms in Hinduism. Reform movement in Hinduism started with full vigor once the appeal of new religions vanished. So people realized that they needed to bring in some changes. Hinduism assimilated the positive aspects of Buddhism. Assimilated, gathered. Even foreign invaders and settlers adopted Hinduism as their new religion. Among these are included the Shakas and the Satvahanas. Now let us see another reason for the decline of Buddhism. Invasions. From the 8th century AD, the Turkish invasion dealt a blow to Buddhism. The monasteries which had accumulated great wealth were looted. The invaders plundered the monasteries of Nalanda and Takshila and forced some of the monks to flee to neighboring countries like Nepal and Tibet. Now, end of royal patronage. Rajput rulers were warlike and could not follow the policy of Ahimsa. Being Kshatriyas, they had to fight, and when they are fighting, they needed to kill also or destroy the enemy. So it did not agree with the philosophy of Buddhism. Besides, the kings of Gupta period patronized temples in honor of Hindu gods and goddesses. Thus, the lack of royal patronage brought about decline of Buddhism. Now, Jainism and Buddhism compare. Let us see the similarities between the two sects which became popular. The founders of both religions, Mahavir and Gautam Buddha, had similar backgrounds. Both of them belonged to the Kshatriya clan and followed the same path. Both sought the attainment of salvation from the cycle of birth and death. Both did not accept the Vedas. Non-violence was their creed. Monks and nuns of Buddhism and Jainism had to renounce family life and the world. They had to lead a life of chastity. So all these points were common between the two sects of Jainism and Buddhism. Now let us see the dissimilarities. Just like the similarities, children, the dissimilarities are also important. It was completely a new religion in the 6th century BC. It had been founded long before Mahavira. He was the last of its Tirthankars. Buddhism followed a middle path, whereas Jainism believed in hard penance. So this was one of the major reasons why Jainism lost its popularity. Buddhism spread far and wide and led to cultural evolution in India, whereas Jainism did not spread beyond the Indian shores. Now, Buddhism is silent about the existence of God. Please note it down in your books. As this is also a very important point. Whereas Jainism, believes in the existence of God, devices or the existence of God. So children, most important thing is that you need to read the chapter once again. Please keep on underlining each and everything. And it's not necessary that the questions which are given at the back of the chapter, only those will be asked, but anything can be asked from in between the chapter, especially when we are talking about your boards. So please underline everything, learn everything from in between the chapter, try and read the topics again, and if there is some problem which you have not understood any particular topic, then we will talk about it, discuss it in details later. Thank you.